Welcome to the adventure of Compton's Interactive Encyclopedia, a journey into knowledge. I'm Patrick Stewart, and I'm here to guide you on a personal tour through this powerful, yet easy-to-use multimedia universe of information. This is the encyclopedia's main screen, or the tableau screen. The three windows are called viewers. The large viewer on the right is where articles appear. Beside it is the multimedia viewer for displaying pictures, animations, and video clips. The row of buttons is called the path bar. Each button opens an exciting pathway into the encyclopedia, such as the atlas or the timeline. When you click on a path button, the path appears in the bottom window, the path viewer. Each of the paths offers dynamic tools for research and exploration. Each viewer window has a button marked full screen, allowing you to click to full magnification at any time. At the bottom of the screen, you'll find the message bar. As you move the cursor around the screen, messages appear here, explaining exactly what the cursor is on. If at any time you desire additional help, click on the Explain button next to the message bar. The cursor will become a question mark. Move it over anything you want to know about. Click again. You will immediately hear a brief explanation, or I'll appear to assist you. I particularly like that feature. I thank you for briefly exploring this powerful, interactive wonder with me. Now, go, explore, and enjoy. The adventure is yours.
Thank you. Japan. This country is a land of high-speed trains, modern buildings, massive industry, teeming highways, and commuter stress. Modern Japan, rivaling the most advanced economic powers of the West, seems a long way from the traditions of its past. Japan's phenomenal success in economic development since World War II is based in part upon its many highly trained scientists, engineers, and technicians. This economic success is considered by many to be a modern-day miracle.
The end of communist rule in several East European countries in 1989 spelled the fall of the Berlin Wall. The resignation of the East German government was the final blow. The 28-year-old wall was opened, and East Germans quickly took care of the rest. In March 1990, free elections were held in East Germany, and later that year, the governments of East and West Germany were united. The 45-year-old Cold War was over. In 1979, in the face of demonstrations, strikes, and riots against his rule, and fearing for his life, the Shah of Iran fled his country, taking refuge in the United States. Iran's many conservative factions, believing that the Shah's modernization programs violated traditional Islamic teachings, united under a religious leader, Ayatollah Khomeini, then in exile in Paris. Khomeini returned triumphantly to set up a new government based on the fundamentalist teachings of Islam.
The large heavenly bodies in our solar system that revolve in orbits around the sun are called planets. Mercury is the planet closest to the sun. Venus is next. Earth, the third planet, appears to be the only planet that supports life. The remaining planets, in order from the Sun, are Mars, often called the Red Planet, Jupiter, which is larger than all other planets combined, and Saturn, known for its rings. Uranus comes next, followed by Neptune and tiny Pluto, the smallest of the nine known planets, seen here in this false color image as a bright blur.
In the capsule dubbed Friendship 7, astronaut John Glenn became the first American to orbit the Earth, circling the globe three times on February 20, 1962. At a height of some 100 miles above the Earth, Glenn went from daylight to darkness to daylight in less than 2 hours. Glenn plunged into the Atlantic Ocean near the West Indies and was picked up 15 minutes later, suffering no ill effects from his 5 hours of weightlessness. Mission accomplished.
Click on the item you'd like explained.
Click on Exit to quit the Compton's Interactive Encyclopedia.